the nature of nature, what is the reality of nature, and how do we know that we know what we know? Well, we're all agreed that the classical Newtonian Cartesian paradigm is gone. It doesn't hold up to what we're observing through our very fine instruments. Wolfgang Schmidt's interpretation, how do we make sense? What is then actually happening? And he says that this idea of not that the physical object doesn't exist, but that the object is not a particle or a wave or anything, not this or that, until we have actually observed it. And then it becomes that and not any of the other possibilities. What is this? And this, he says, the best way to understand this is to use the old Greek paradigm of hylomorphy, the hylomorphic paradigm, in which in nature what means, what manifestation, what we see is hyl and morph, which the Greeks explained with the example of, let's say, a sculpture of Aristotle or Adonis, either in marble or wood. So the marble or wood is the hyl, which takes the form, or which receives the morph. Morph is the form. Now, but in this traditional paradigm, hyl is not to be confused with matter. It is not something that exists in time and space. It is a potentiality which receives morph, that is form. And neither is morph an entity that exists in time and space. It exists outside. What you have is, and you, further you can illustrate this with the little experiment that you did just now, with your blank piece of paper. The Euclidean plane, which is the basis of all our geometry. The traditional view of the Euclidean plane is that it doesn't actually exist anywhere. Until you put your pencil on the paper, you have determined a point, and you make another point, you have determined a space. It didn't exist before. So you see, in both of these models, the idea of something that did not exist as a corporeal, that's the other thing. Wolfgang Schmidt says the only way to make sense of what we're observing is to recognize that there are two different entities. There is the corporeal entity, which we experience, which we observe directly through our senses. And there not perceive, it is not perceivable except through instruments. The instruments in turn, of course, are corporeal objects which we can then see, and through them we get to know the physical entity. So this is, and by the way, if you just extend that little exercise, what we have then is the corporeal object, the dot, the line, the circle which you make on paper. And we have the physical entity which the physicist measures. But I could have, when I asked you what is this you made, instead of a point, somebody might have said it's a bug, an ant. Or the point of my pencil seemed straight out like that. Nobody said, but you could have said that. So we have another third world. You have the corporeal world, you have the physical world, and you have the subjective, the psychological world, which you imagine. So there are not one simple, it's the same thing that you're looking at. So what we have is a reality which is one and unbroken, which does not exist in time-space, but it manifests itself, the same reality manifests itself, sometimes as a particle, sometimes as a wave, and sometimes as a point, sometimes as so many atoms and molecules. These are the infinite manifestations of a metaphysical reality. So that's an important point to keep in mind, which comes out of at least Wolfgang Smith and a few other scientists suggest this paradigm, which is really the traditional paradigm of what nature actually is.